Come on to the Minecraft file. Jimmy Swift skills will drive you wild. From the treehouse to a city bank, it's the Minecraft Files all day.
Hey, what's going on, Swifters? It's Jimmy Swift here, and welcome back to the Minecraft Files. This is episode 21 in season 4, and today is Friday, which means it's TQF, which stands for Triple Question Friday. I never get tired of saying that. Ah, oh, it's so much fun. Okay, so if you do not know what TQF means, that means that every Friday, I take three questions from you guys that you leave in the Swifter section, also known as the comment section, on the previous Friday's video, and I answer them during this Friday. And also because it's like the granddaddy video of the week, I set a goal for you guys every single week, and the goal for this week is 20,000 likes! So if you're watching this video right now, please take a quick second to hit that like button down below the video. It's the least you can do to help support me and show me that you guys really, really do enjoy and support and love a long-standing, long-lasting series, that being the Minecraft Files, which, if you're brand new to my channel, is the longest series that I have on my channel. I've actually been doing it since the very, very, very beginning. The very first video that I uploaded on my channel back in February 2011 was a Minecraft Files episode, and still today, because of your guys' amazing support and support on videos like this, I am continuing to do that, to do these episodes for you guys. So, today, we're going to be making a swimming pool with a floating chair, and that request comes from DodgersFan2K9. Now, unfortunately, today's video is going to probably be a little bit short, and we're going to go ahead and roll into the announcements here. The reason for that and the announcement is that I'm actually going home tomorrow to my parents' house. They live about 3 hours away from where I currently live now that I moved and everything, and I'm just going home to visit them for a day or so, and right now the time I'm recording this is 11:45 p.m. on Friday, so it's like really late, and I need to get some sleep, and I have to drive 3 hours tomorrow, and so this episode can't be all that long. Now, chances are it'll probably be a little bit longer than I want it to. That's usually how I operate. That's usually how things end up going, unfortunately. So I do apologize for that, and I'm sorry that this episode probably won't be as long as you guys may have liked. However, last week's episode was like an hour and a half, which was pretty freaking awesome. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a pool directly in the ocean. We're going to just make this directly in the ocean, and the reason I'm doing that is because I was getting tired of making swimming pools and then having to fill them up with buckets and buckets and buckets of water, and I decided, you know what, let's do something a little bit different here today, and let's build the actual swimming pool in the ocean itself. So I know a couple episodes back when I built the bar, I said that I didn't really want to build a swimming pool. I was just going to make a bar and have that be sort of the same as, or the swim-up bar, as it was a, here, I'll show you guys here in a minute. Basically, the bar was accessible, you could swim to it, and I didn't think that it was necessary to sort of have an actual swimming pool, but I decided it would be kind of cool because there are actually these beach float chairs things that you can use within this mod. So right here, this like little area right here, I was just sort of like, oh yeah, we're going to make a private beach and then a swimming area right here, which is still a swimming area, of course. But I thought it'd be kind of cool to make a pool anyways. Now I'm going to come over here and grab my flippers because we are going to use these. So let's get our flippers on. And all right, there we go. So now we're going to walk all slow. All right, so let's go finish this sucker up. And because it's TQF, let's go ahead and take our first question of the day, which comes from, let me see here. Comes from J6PackBoy200, who says, Chimney, do you do any urban sports, parkour, skateboarding, etc.? No, I do not. Actually, I own a skateboard. It's at my parents' house currently. I tried skateboarding when I was younger. One of my high school friends and I like really got into it one time, and he was a lot better than I was. I'm terrible, like just absolutely terrible. And so, no, I don't do any, I mean, I joke around and do like joking parkour and stuff. Like my brother and I, we used to like run around like this place that we used to hang out a lot, and we'd like jump off of stuff and be like parkour, and this was like even way before, you know, like most people knew about parkour, at least within the Minecraft community, and how like, you know, parkour sort of came about. Parkour has obviously been around for a while. I'm not saying that it hasn't been around for a while or anything. That'd be stupid. But basically, yeah, we would just jump off stuff and be like, parkour! And joking around and whatever. But no, I don't do any sort of serious parkour, urban sports or anything like that. If you do, that's super awesome. Because I definitely respect people that do that. They definitely take a beating. Their bodies definitely take a beating by doing that stuff, and it's pretty cool. It's pretty entertaining to watch, especially with like the X Games and stuff. I always liked watching the X Games with Sal Masekela, the host from ESPN. Yeah, he's a cool guy. Watching the X Games and all that fun stuff on TV and everything. Those are always really fun to watch. I'm actually really, really looking forward to the Olympics too. The Olympics are like next week. I can't believe it. I love the Olympics. I'm a big sports guy too. You guys may or may not know that about me. I love watching the Olympics. It is fun, and we are going to run into sandstone. I collected a whole ton before this too. We're going to have to go collect some more. That's going to be not cool. I'm really, really excited to watch the Olympics, next week. It should be a good time. Oh gosh, I'm misplacing blocks like freaking crazy. All right. So I hope you guys had a good week. I had a pretty good week. It's pretty crazy what happened today or last night in Colorado with that shooting at the movie theater. That's pretty crazy. Did you guys hear about that? Thoughts and prayers definitely go out to those families and the victims and everything of those that were shot or were involved in that incident. That was pretty crazy and scary. I was talking to some friends today, though. It's not going to keep me from seeing the movie. I think that I'm going to still want to see The Dark Knight Rises in theaters. But it's crazy to think that people can do that, and it's just craziness. So, anyways, let's go ahead and get on a more positive note here. I don't want to depress you guys too much. If you want to get depressed, go watch the news. But let me go ahead and finish this thing. We're going to need probably a little bit more sandstone. I may actually have some back in the house. I didn't even check before I collected any. I wanted to make it out of sandstone because I thought that was kind of a cool... Would look cool for a pool. I'm not trying to rhyme here intentionally or anything. I tell you what, these flippers definitely make building underwater so much easier. You don't sink down. It's quite awesome! So I will be gone like tomorrow for the whole day. I will have videos going out though for you guys. So there will be videos going out. And this pool is very narrow. Maybe it's like an Olympic pool, like a training pool or something. No, I will have videos going out for you guys. And I pre-recorded some stuff before I left and whatnot. Just so you guys could have some stuff to watch. I hope you guys appreciate that, because it definitely takes a lot of work. I think a lot of people that watch, people like me that do commentaries and stuff, they don't, unless you do that yourself, I don't feel like people fully appreciate or value the amount of work that goes into some of these things. Like, I get people that say, like, you know, oh, Chimney, you know, you're such an idiot, you messed this up, yada, 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 when you're doing this, all this stuff, and I'm like, really, if you when you're recording and you're trying to constantly keep a dialogue with your audience, it's a lot harder to like play well in the game, like whether it's Minecraft or what. It doesn't really matter. I don't think a lot of people realize that. Like somebody, I think, had posted something on the most recent Super Spellbound Caves, and they were like, you know, saying, you know, that I was an idiot for like messing this thing up or whatever. And I'm just like, really? Like, you try and record and do this at the same time. It's not easy, okay? It's not easy. So anyways, that's that. All right, so we've got our pool here, and what we're going to do now is we're going to throw a pool party. That's what I want to do today. We're going to throw a pool party with some pina coladas and some beach chairs. And what we need to do is I would like to make sort of a pier/bridge thing out to there. Now, I want to take out these man-of-war jellyfish, because we don't need them around our pool. We just don't need them around the pool. We don't need them around the pool. So let's go ahead and poach them away from right up here. Yeah. Oh, did I hit him? No, I didn't hit him. Oh! One-shot kill. Oh, sniper. Not everyone. There's a sniper in the midst. And he's got a bow and an arrow, and he's on fire. You cannot touch him. All right. So let's go collect our loot down here. Our mob loot. Mob loot. Oh, there we go. Here we go. We got a slime ball and some experience orbs. Oh, I keep trying to press shift to go downwards. It's not working because I'm not wearing my flippers. Whoops. All right, let's grab this. Then we're going to go sleep, and then we're going to go make a floating device thing. Why are you not picking that up? Why? I hate it when the things glitch out like that. There's a slime ball down there, and it's completely... We could use it. All right, pal. Hey, pal. There we go. Nope. Come on, let's get this one. Please work. There we go. What the heck? That's so weird that it didn't do it. The last one. Koala bear! I would invite you to the pool party, but I'm afraid you're going to run away. I'm sorry. I'm afraid you're going to run away. I don't know. I just don't trust you right now. I feel like you're still kind of mad at me for luring you all the way out here with a pina colada. Now, that being said, I would like to go get some monkeys and bring them to the pool party. So we'll see how that goes. All right, let's put these away. And, oh my gosh, we are... Okay, we can make some more wool. All right, so let's do that. Let's take this and... Ooh, you know what we need, though? We are going to need some more dye. Now, I'm going to take this encyclopedia here. I'm going to look this up because I want to see what colors we can make. Now, the beach chairs can be different colors here. So, light blue. That's it. Light blue. I want light blue because we can actually make that right now. I think I have... Oh, nuts. Where's all the bone meal? Oh, wait, we got some bones here. So, light blue dye. Is that all the lapis we have for real? Like, one piece? How did we only get one piece? I don't think we dyed anything, did we? Seriously? Alright, well, I don't think that... Actually, this is going to take up more inventory space. Okay, let's run back to the mainland. I'm going to grab another piece of lapis lazuli, and we're going to make another little thingy of light blue dye here, because I want to make a basically a beach float out of the light. I want it to be light blue, basically. So that's the plan, and then we're going to throw it in the pool, have a pool party, and it's going to be a grand old time. We're going to build a little bridge to the pool and everything. And all that fun stuff. Okay, so let's go down here. Welcome back to the season 3 world. If you missed season 3, you should totally check it out. And also down below, on the left hand side, the bottom left hand side of your guys' screen, you'll see a little icon that says you're watching, and then, you know, like, usually right now it'll say you're watching TQF. On other videos of the Minecraft files, it'll just say you're watching the Minecraft files. And what you can do if you're watching on your computer is you can actually click that. If there's an annotation on that and you're watching on your PC, you can click that, and what it's going to do is it will take you to the playlist or the show page. And what you can do is you can subscribe to the Minecraft files show there, so you don't miss out on any time an episode is added to the Minecraft files. Sometimes if you miss it in your sub box or whatever, maybe because I uploaded it late or whatever one night. Usually in a day or so, I will post that and sort of add it to the show page, and it will get sent back to your sub box, which is kind of cool. So that way you won't miss episodes. But if you did miss an episode and you're trying to catch up, a really easy way of catching up on any missed episodes is to just click that little annotation down there in the bottom. And then what you can go ahead and do is you can look for the episodes that you missed within the playlist there. So that's pretty cool. I did that for you guys because I thought that that might help you out. I also do it for Super Spellbound Caves as well, in case you miss any episodes. Just want to make sure that you guys are... It's very, very... I wanted to make it very, very easy for you guys to catch up on episodes should you have ever missed them, basically. So that's sort of the plan. All right. So... I'm trying to think of how to make this beach float. I'm not entirely sure.
This may take some experimentation.
That's a beach chair. We don't want to make a beach chair. How do you make a beach float? I used to know this. Man. It's like this page right there. Dang it. Oh my gosh. I may have to look this up online real fast for you guys. Yeah, let me do that real quick and I'll be right back. Alright, Swifter. So I figured it out, and basically all you gotta do is you gotta take bamboo right there and then you put your color on top of that, and there you go. You got yourself a beach float. So let's take our beach float out there. But before we do, let's go ahead and answer another question from TQF. And this question comes from 16Army6, who says, what is your dream car? My dream car is probably either a BMW or... did you guys ever see the TV show called Burn Notice? There's a TV show on there called Burn Notice, one of my all-time favorite shows. The car that Michael Weston in that show drives has got to be like one of my all-time favorite cars and would probably be a dream car if I were to ever have one. It's like a, I think it's like a 1963 or 1973 Dodge Charger. And it looks amazing in that show. It looks really, really cool. And I would totally love to own one of those sometime, which would be really, really sweet. So, all right, let me go ahead and decorate this, this pool a little bit. Now, as time goes on, I will probably make the pool deck a little bit bigger because it's a little bit frustratingly, like, just derpy right now. It's like really, really thin. But that being said, I want to go ahead and make our little bridge, our little walkway, because I don't have that much time, and I do apologize, you guys. Sorry that I don't have time to give you a long episode tonight. I'm worried. Like I said, I have to drive tomorrow, and I also have to still stay up late tonight to pre-upload all the videos for you guys for tomorrow, so that they can go out tomorrow while I'm gone. It's a tough job here that I'm doing for you guys. It's definitely time-consuming, and I want to make sure that I'm well rested before I drive so I don't like fall asleep at the wheel or something stupid like that. So, before we call this episode off and say that it's done, we got to kick back and have a pina colada at this pool party. I mean, this is what Tropicraft is all about, right? At its core, this is what Tropicraft is all about. All right, so let's put these away. Let's put the lapis away. All this stuff. Sand, sandstone, blah, 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 blah. Okay. Oops, there we go. Do this. Pina colada. And let's put some of these. I need to put some of these blocks away. Oh, no. So sorry about that, Mr. Shell. All right. Now, what I will do at some point as well is I'm going to go ahead and add in some of the glowstone, like do some glowstone blocks underneath the water so that it sort of like lights up a little bit. I think that'll look kind of cool. What is this, sand? Normal sand. Let's put that there. And right there, put these guys away. All right, so let's go enjoy our new pool party. Yes, having a pool party. This is gonna be super fun. Actually, do I have any? I don't have enough. We need like two floats in it. That would be kind of cool, right? I think that would be kind of cool. How much string do we have here? Oh, we have enough. We have enough. We have enough. We have enough. Yes. Oh, that's amazing. All right. Oh no, we don't have enough of these guys. Let's make this episode a little bit longer. Let's make it a little bit longer. It's not gonna end yet. What are you talking about? I'm not ending this episode yet. We're gonna make a, here, let's see. Let's do beach floats. What colors do these come in? Red, yellow, lime, ooh, and magenta wool. Let's do that. I'm feeling like magenta wool right now. So we'll have like a blue and a magenta float. Let me go back to the mainland because all like the dye stuff is in there that I have. I could probably get it from In This World and Tropicraft. Like you can craft down like the coral and stuff to get the dyes, but I don't feel like going hunting for it right now. I'd rather and I don't want to destroy like the I don't want to destroy the coral reefs that I have. So we are going to make some magenta wool, and we're going to do that down here. Now, all my dyes, I think, are in here. Yes. Okay, so we have magenta, and magenta is made with... Is it red with blue, and then... Oh my gosh, I'm totally blanking right now. I used to know everything about the dyes. I used to know everything. So I know that red and blue makes purple. But does purple and let's see, I don't have any purple and bone meal. Does that make magenta? Or is it purple and pink? I bet it's purple and pink. That's probably what it is. Yes. It's purple and pink. So, pink is red with bone meal. So let's do that. Oh, these silly crafting recipes. Alright, let's take these guys, get some rose red dye, and take the pink, and then we'll take the... There we go. Perfect. Alright, so I'll just take this stuff with me. Just in case. Yeah, let's take it. Alright, so the wool, we're gonna do magenta. 3 pieces of magenta wool. And I don't have any bamboo. Whoops. Alright. Quiet cats, you be quiet! Like the crazy cat lady. You be quiet! Stop meowing! I'll feed you your tuna salad later. All right, let's go back in here. Oh, what a weirdo. And we'll add another beach float to this. I wish that one of you sisters could join me in this pool party. This would be fun. All right. So let's go sleep here. Whee! Pool parties are fun. We should make like a beach umbrella for that too. Yeah, let's do that. Let's make a beach umbrella for the pool as well. See if we can get a few more decorations going before I actually end this episode. Cause I always feel bad when I give you guys a short TQF episode. Like, I shouldn't, and I'm gonna not feel bad, but I sort of want to feel bad sometimes because I know like you guys like the long episodes or whatever. Like I said, there's really nothing I can do. Oh no! I left all the wool back there. Let's screw it. Let's not do the beach umbrella here. We'll just do a purple beach float. Or magenta. Excuse me, it's magenta! I'm sorry! Our beach umbrella is right here. Okay, so here we go. Another float there. And let's light this up a little. What? Last torch, are you kidding? All right, let's do, come on now, cooperate. There we go. All right, so here we go. Can I lay on the, oh, sick! That's amazing! Do you guys see this? I'm even kicking. Oh, this is so freaking relaxing. No way. All right, well, let's go ahead and end the episode on this thing. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna pack all this in. So my question for you guys this episode, and you gotta leave your comment down in the Swifter section below, is what do you like to do outside of playing video games? That's what I wanna know. What do you like to do outside of playing video games? Leave your comment down below. Also, the final question of TQF comes from DarkNintendo2000, who says, you say you like breakfast, so what's better? Pancakes, waffles, cereal, or French toast? Honestly, that relies on, here, let me get out of here. How do I get out of here? Did I just break it? Is that what I do? Honestly, that relies on, it just relies on what type of morning it is. There we go. Now we got some open space. Here, let's get rid of the HUD. There we go. Nice. So relaxing. It depends on what kind of morning it is. It depends on what I'm feeling like. Some mornings cereal sounds amazing. Almost every morning, pancakes sound amazing. Like, literally almost every single morning that I'm alive, pancakes sound amazing. So I probably have to say pancakes. Waffles are amazing too, but I think pancakes, the fluffiness of the pancake is just like, so good. And finally, if you've watched this entire video, all you gotta do is write in the comment section down below there, Harry Heffalump. Harry Heffalump. If you don't know what Heffalumps are, they're from Winnie the Pooh. I don't know where I come up with this crazy stuff, but let's go ahead and slurp. Slurp, slurp. There we go. Go ahead and slurped on our pina colada there. Did that give me a buff? Wait a minute. I kid you not. That looked like it gave me some sort of a really, really quick buff. Which leads me to one more question before we end this episode for once and for all. Is that it looked like there were little swirlies coming out of my body after I drank that. And I want to know if there was some sort of a buff on me after I drink this pina colada. So let's drink this pina colada and we're gonna find out what special powers we get from this thing. Now, oh wait, okay, I guess we can do this. All right, here we go. Nausea? What? Seriously? That's a bad buff. Why would I get nausea after drinking pina colada? It's like a tropical relaxing drink. Who knows? Maybe it's because we're, oh, it's because we're drunk. It's an alcoholic beverage. That's right. Getting a little bit drunk here. Getting slurpy drunk all up in this place. All right, you guys. Well, that's going to about do it for this episode and this week's TQF. Like I said, I'm sorry that this was a little bit shorter than what you're probably used to. Next Friday, hopefully, will be a little bit of a longer one. But if you enjoyed this episode, please be sure to hit that like button down below. Add this video to your favorites. It really helps me out and shows you're loving and active and awesome support. Blah! And let's try and hit that goal of 20,000 likes and show YouTube what's going on. Also, if you guys are interested in checking out an amazing new live-action show from Machinima, it's called Daybreak. It's really awesome. It's featured on my channel right now. I will include a link to that video down below in the description. Super high quality. Like, I don't even know how to describe it, really. It's basically this guy, and he's, like, been taken to prison because – or he's been taken under the police because his, like, father died, and this, like – reporter came and asked some questions about it, and then like the reporter's dead, and then like they had suspicion that this guy killed him, but he doesn't remember anything. So it sounds really, really cool. Sounds super awesome, and it's got some cool actors in it too. Actually, if you guys had seen the TV show Chuck, it's got like one of the actors from Chuck in it. The guy that plays Captain Awesome from Chuck, he's in it. Pretty cool. So, anyways, that's gonna about do it for TQF, and I love you guys so much. I will see you again on Monday for another episode, and yeah, slurp.